there's an underwater volcano off Oregon's coast. And it's been a little grumpy.
We're moving! Woohoo!
That's why these scientists are headed out to sea. Volcanologist Bill Chadwick is chief scientist on this cruise. He's been on dozens of these research trips to undersea volcanoes all over the world.
I remember somebody telling me, yeah, being at sea, it's kind of like being in jail, except you can drown.
Bill's family has come to bid bon voyage to him and his daughter, Kelly, who's come along as a data logger on the trip.
And back in the old days, they didn't have internet on the ships. Dad telling me that, like, when he would call my mom when I was a baby, it was, like, over the radio.
Like, yeah, it's like ham radio from the ship. I love you, over. Everybody else.
Your love for me's over?
Yeah.
The ship's destination for the next 2 weeks is the Axial Seamount, a highly active volcano located 300 miles off the Oregon coast.
Axial is the most active volcano in the Northeast Pacific, which maybe some people don't know because it's hidden under the ocean, but it's actually more active than any of the volcanoes we're familiar with, like the ones in the Cascades, Mount St. Helens, Mount Hood, Mount Rainier, because it's erupted 3 times in the last 25 years.
Bill has been studying the Axial Seamount for more than 2 decades, in part trying to figure out how to predict volcanic eruptions.
This is kind of a natural laboratory where we can make forecasts without worrying about it's going to be a false alarm. You know, here there's just a bunch of tube worms and octopuses on the seafloor. They don't care.
The Axial Seamount sits on the Juan de Fuca Ridge, where 2 tectonic plates are spreading apart.
There's volcanic activity all up and down the ridge, and that's where new seafloor is created by eruptions.
It's a shield volcano, like you'd find in Hawaii or Iceland, meaning it doesn't blow its top when it erupts. Instead, the magma below causes it to crack open on its slopes and ooze syrupy lava. As chief scientist on the ship, it's Bill's job to make sure all the science that needs to get done gets done.
Launch when ready.
We are ready to go in the
mission. Copy that.
We're working around the clock. We don't want any downtime. We want to be go, 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 go.
One of the first tasks for the team is to recover a pressure recording instrument that's been sitting atop the volcano, now a mile below the ship.
We just sent the release code to an instrument that's been on the seafloor for the last 2 years.
Just let us know when it's on the way up.
You got it. We'll do.
The code is sent by this transducer as a sound through the water.
Okay, now I'm going low power.
Okay.
When the instrument on the bottom hears the right sequence of chirps, it releases from its weighted base and floats to the surface.
Coming up.
Bridge, bridge, back deck.
Yeah, go ahead.
Hey, it's on its way up.
Over the next week, everyone settles in on the ship.
Atmosphere, we're going to come up.
The scientists and engineers get all the different research projects going.
Ryan, that's good, that's good.
Came back, one piece. Gotta open it up.
Here we go.
There's not many opportunities in life to spend all of your waking moments interacting with other scientists and doing research. It's very busy, there's a lot going on. It is a very science-focused time. It's also a lot of hard work, and often we don't get enough sleep.
We're okay.
Bill's research involves measuring the movement of the volcano as it's pushed up by the magma below.
So the seafloor goes up and down, you know, like 2.5 to 3.5 meters, which is, you know, 8 to 10 feet. So that's a lot of motion.
His instruments are placed on the seafloor by Jason, a remotely operated submarine.
what we can learn from this system and hopefully apply to volcanoes on land that do have the potential to cause lots of harm and to kill people is really valuable.
Once Jason dips below the waves, the crew in the control center, called the van, take over.
The north edge of it is just...
Being in the van is like being on another planet.
There is a bit of a pinch myself to check. Oh wait, this is amazing. This is completely awesome.
This could be good.
It's still magic for Bill, and I know he's done dozens and dozens of these dives.
But Bill Chadwick hasn't always been a seagoing volcanologist. He got his start on a much more famous Northwest volcano.
The big thing for me was Mount St. Helens erupted when I was in college. Before I knew it, I was getting in a helicopter and flying into the crater of Mount St. Helens. I decided then I was like an adrenaline junkie or something. I want to do more of that. That was like super fun.
Volcanoes became a fixture of his life.
My mom is also a geologist, and so they're like huge nerds about this stuff. So whenever we go on vacation, we always go, like, we have to go look at the cool rocks. And so I've seen so much lava in my life.
And soon, Bill found another passion, exploring volcanoes under the ocean. A big part of his work has been axial.
I think that Bill has played a huge role in the interest of axial seamount. You know, they put this pressure instrument down in 1998, and when they came back to pick the instrument up, miraculously, they had recorded an eruption. And so that was just sort of, you know, instant interest in axial.
Using their data, Bill and his research partner, Scott Nooner, predicted the 2015 axial eruption about 7 months in advance.
This was the first accurate volcanic eruption forecast on the planet, based off ground deformation data alone. So they won't tell you that, but it's pretty cool.
One of Jason's planned stops is a group of hydrothermal vents in the axial seamount's caldera.
There's all this heat underground. The ocean water circulates underground, gets heated up, comes out at hydrothermal vents.
Swapping out the temperature gauges requires precision from the pilot controlling Jason's claws. The angle has to be perfect to get the probe down into the vent. With the job done, the crew takes some time to investigate the thriving life around the vents.
It's full of chemical energy, and there's microbes and whole ecosystems that have evolved to take advantage of that energy.
On the left, there's the sulfite worms, have their red pomprons sticking out, and then a few scale worms crawling around, grazing on the bacteria.
Whoa!
Even though the scientific work runs around the clock, the crew does take time to unwind.
It's kind of like you're going camping with a bunch of people, a floating camping.
Complete with art projects.
When everything goes well, we'll do a nice art project. So this time we made a giant octopus.
The details.
Maybe a little
higher.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Close encounters with wildlife.
Anything is there?
What?
Oh my gosh. Okay. Oh my gosh. Okay.
If the boat was lower to the ocean, I feel like you could have reached out and touched it.
And what the scientists refer to as variable gravity ping pong.
Trying to cheat.
Play a little ping pong occasionally, yeah, that's right. I think there aren't that many fields in science that you can make close connections with people in quite the same way.
The final 36 hours on the Axial Seamount has come, and there's still a lot of science to fit in.
He's looking stressed about the schedule.
And this is where Bill, as chief scientist, earns his keep. The schedule is proving tricky.
Yeah. Chief scientist? That could be the story.
Yeah.
Same trend. Schedule.
Put him in the brig in the straitjacket with
the
manacles.
Yeah, with the manacles on.
But with a little more juggling,
it might work.
Now he needs to get everyone on the same page.
They want to capture on camera the moment when I have a mental breakdown.
Oh, good.
First, the crew of Sentry, the yellow submarine.
All right, so.
Then a check-in on Jason.
Bill, any word on when these floats are coming?
With some stops along the way.
Definitely delayed.
Okay. Oh, Bill.
What?
Which one is going first?
The north one.
All right, here we go.
So, Akel, you would still like to have some time on deck?
I would. That'd be great.
So, I have a scenario where that could barely work.
Next stop, up to the bridge to clear things with the ship's crew.
Only two more to go. Our exercise for the day.
And then right back down again to the main lab.
All right. So, this is called the Board of Lies. The more items I put on here, the more chance of it being a lie. I'm getting into deep lie territory here. That's what the rest of the cruise looks like. Whew.
Let's do it.
You know, at the beginning of my career, not much was known about deep sea volcanoes at all.
For a while, Axial seemed like it was headed for another eruption. But the data collected on this cruise shows that it's still likely several years away.
If you think you know what's going on, nature will usually make you humbler by doing something you didn't expect. Yeah, it's just really fun to try to figure it all out.
And the story of Bill and the volcano is not over yet. There's still plenty more to learn about the Pacific Northwest's most active volcano.
Getting inspiration for your next adventure. It's kind of why you're here, right? Well, you can support more of what we do on Oregon Field Guide and everything else you see on OPB by going to opb.org/video and becoming a sustaining member.